Hello all and welcome to this video. In our video today, we will discuss the differences between a data lake, a data warehouse, and a database. Of late, a whole lot of people have asked as to what is the difference between a data lake, a data warehouse, and a database. And that is probably because of the increasing popularity of data lakes as well. So in this particular video, let us understand what are the differences between these three. So in this slide, basically, I have taken a couple of criteria as you see right here. And for each of these criteria, we will see as to how a database behaves, a data warehouse behaves, and how a data lake behaves. Okay. The first criteria over here is the type of data. Now, I believe you already know, most of you have worked with databases and you guys understand very clearly and easily that the type of data that is stored in a database is structured in nature. In sense, it has certain structure, like, hey, it's a table, it has certain keys, it may have a primary key, it may have a foreign key. You know, there are some basic relations going on, especially in an RDBMS. So essentially a database data is stored in a specific structure, okay? Like for example, your tables. It's in the data warehouse as well. Data is stored in a structured manner. Again, you have tables, you have several other objects that you can store your data in as well. But when it comes to data lakes, okay, the data is stored in an unstructured manner. For example, you could store them as flat files, you could store it as the raw data that you had received from somewhere, which could be just a chunk of XML or just some plain simple text. It could be anything. You know, you could pretty much store the data in any format or any structure in a data lake. And that's one of the key differences between a database, a data warehouse, and a data lake is the type of data it stores. Okay, data lake is one of those which stores unstructured data. So this is very important. Okay, especially this could be asked to you in an interview as well. Let's say like if you go for an interview and say, and they might just ask you casually like, hey, what is the difference between a data lake and a database, or a data warehouse and a database, or a data warehouse and a data lake. Okay, so the idea is keep in mind all of these criteria and then compare them in your head and then accordingly answer the question that, hey, this is the difference between these two or these three. The next point that we have over here is data normalized? That means the data that is stored, is that in a normalized format? Okay, you remember there are like four normal forms or three normal forms depending upon what level. But most of the data is at least normalized to the third normal form. So in a database, as you know, yes, the data is normalized. You do have your primary tables or your key tables, and you have your relational tables as well, wherein you can set up a primary and a foreign key relationship, or a primary key, unique key relationship, whatever the case may be. Okay, so in a database, the data is in a normalized format. In a data warehouse, data is generally not stored in a normalized format. And the reason behind it being is it is used for reporting and analytics. In fact, the data will be denormalized, okay, especially for reporting, and will be stored in a denormalized format. So that's something that you need to remember. Again, a key difference between database and a data lake. And in a data lake, the data does not have any structure. So it could be in any form, as I said. So the idea of normalization is not even relevant. So the answer to that question, is the data normalized, is no. The next criteria that I have selected over here is the type of operation. Okay, that means what type of operations or what kind of applications, when you say that an application is using a database, what type of data does this application store? And then what is the nature of the transaction that is being made, or the way the data is being stored or what type of data is being stored itself. Okay, so typically databases are used for online transaction processing. That means, let's say you are on a website and the website is making some kind of e-commerce, or it could be anything else, you know, like it could be creation, it could be plain simple CRUD operations that could be performed as well. It could be anything, but the idea would be that, hey, let's go ahead and, you know, create an employee, or you could place an order on a website. It could be anything. So the idea is essentially that it is used for online transaction processing. Okay, whatever transaction happens will be stored in the database. And hence, you will see that most of the operations are atomic in nature. You know, it forms, it basically even follows the ACID properties. So keep this in mind that typically databases are used for online transaction processing or OLTP. Contrary to that, a data warehouse is used for online analytical processing. As I said, it's more for generally used for reporting and analytics. So you could be running reports, you could be running aggregate queries, you could be performing some analysis, you know, you could be creating some kind of a model. It could be an analytical model, an OLAP model, depending upon whatever you want to do. And you will see generally most of these are background processes which goes on versus, you know, when an online transaction processing, it could be as good as having, you know, some real-time processing happening with the data. But on contrary, for a data warehouse, you know, it's more for something that's back-end, more for reporting, etc. Something that is after your transactions are done. Hey, get me a report of all the various transactions for this particular client. And then you store the data in a denormalized format so that whenever anybody requests that particular report, it can simply just go to a single table and fetch the data and, you know, showcase the data as a part of the report. Or you could be doing some kind of analytics as well. As far as the data lake is concerned, that is typically used for performing raw data analysis. You know, like, hey, what kind of data do I have? What type of data this is? It could be flat files, as I said, it could be XML, it could be anything else that you would want to store as a part of the data. And all this raw data has just been gathered, okay, for analysis, and you do not know what this data has. But the idea is just to gather all this data and then perform any kind of analysis or breakdown. You know, sometimes you will also see that the data is cleansed as well, or transformed to be stored in a specific format. So that is done. All of that is done typically, you know, as a part of the operation for a data. The next point is cost of storing the data. Now, obviously, databases, the cost of storing the data is going to be high, especially RDBMSs. You have license costs, you have disk costs, you have cost of DBAs, you know, maintaining those databases. You have cost of data programmers, or database programmers, I should say, and even data modelers, etc. The overall cost of not only the storing the data and also maintaining the database is far high. Definitely the cost of storing the data is also high, okay? Because as I said, you know, you have to pay for some license, and unless you're using SQL or Oracle, then accordingly, the cost of storing the data in that particular database is going to be high. Similarly, for data warehouses, again, the cost of storing the data is going to be high for the sheer fact that some of these data warehouses, the softwares are extremely expensive. For example, one of the popular ones is Teradata. Teradata is extremely expensive as well. And again, cost of maintenance, you need to have DBAs, etc. All of that is involved. So again, the cost of storing the data is high. Also remember that a data warehouse is again used for reporting analytics. So that means you could have a lot of data in a denormalized format. And for that, you will need large amount of disk space as well. Not necessarily that disk space is very is expensive. In today's world, disk space is cheaper. But depending upon how much data you have, your overall storage cost of storing the data would significantly increase. As far as data lakes is concerned, the cost of storing the data is pretty low. Most of it is, as I said, it's raw data. It's generally stored on disk. You also have some open source softwares as well, which are low in cost, etc. They're not yet as matured as a database or a data warehouse. So hence, the overall cost of storing the data, anyways, the data is in an unstructured format, is significantly lower compared to a database or a data warehouse. The next point that we have is agility, or can I change the data structure easily? Now, obviously, for database, it's going to be no, because again, you have relational data. If you change something, it's not that easy to change primary keys, foreign keys, unique keys, whatever the case may be. Once the database is set, and especially once your application starts using it, then changing the database could become challenging and time consuming. It's not impossible. I'm not saying that it's not possible to change the data. The ease of changing the data structure, the way it has been stored. Let's say you've created your stable structures and your joins and your relationships. Then changing that can be a significant effort and a time-consuming exercise. And the same thing is true for data warehouse as well. Although not as complicated as a database. Again, remember, it stores a lot of denormalized data. So again, if your reports are using it or your analytical application is using this data, then changing the data structure itself can become challenging. It's not going to be as easy compared to a data lake. Again, obviously, changing the data structure is going to be very easy. And a simple answer to that, always keep in mind, is that data lakes are used to store primarily unstructured data. So obviously, if there is no specific structure, then changing the data structure shouldn't be a problem, right? Because there's as such no structure existing. Next point is data security. As you know, in databases, you have logins, you have users, you have encryption. You have all sorts of, master keys you can use to encrypt the entire database, the data at rest. It totally depends. It's up to you what level of data security you need. Okay. In SQL Server, you have the transparent data encryption, the TDE as well. And I'm sure that depending upon each database, there are different kinds of security that is available. Okay, you could use Windows authentication, you could use keys, you could get as fancy as you want. So essentially what I'm trying to say is that databases have been around for a very long time. Hence, their data security is far more matured and robust. Okay, most of these databases are used for production systems, and the access to that, those systems, you have a significant amount of logging, etc., as well as a part of the overall security, so that anybody logs in, there will immediately be an entry. And if a certain user, let's say, is not part of the authorized user and is trying to log in, then it will even set up certain alarms and send out email messages saying that, hey, XYZ was trying to log in. Can you please look into this? So overall data security is extremely mature. And the same thing is true for data warehouses as well. Some of these data warehouses store very sensitive data for reporting purposes. It could be compensation data. It could be healthcare data. Especially healthcare data could be, if it lands into some wrong hands, then the company can get into trouble. It could also be credit card information being stored, etc. So again, the data security for both database and data warehouses is extremely matured and robust. And only a certain set of people who are authorized have access to the database or the data warehouse. Now, on contrary to that, data lakes, data security is still evolving. And obviously, it's fairly new. It's still coming up to speed. And again, most of the technologies that are used to create a data lake are open source. So hence, the data security is not good as a database or a data warehouse, which would more or less act like a product and would have inbuilt, matured data security. Okay, not only matured, even robust and strong. Okay, so the next criteria is the audience or the type of user. Okay, who typically would be using this? Like once somebody asked me, like, who would want to use a data lake? Well, you do have people who use data lakes, and those, and they are called as data scientists. Okay, so keep that in mind. Okay. Also, who would want to use a database? Anybody can use a database. I mean, I believe even college kids, they start with, you know, free SQL Server Express or maybe MS Access, whatever the case may be, or a free version of a database. There's so many databases available. So anybody can use a database. And as long as you're willing to pay the license fees, etc., you could be fine. As I said, you could also get a free version or a light version. As far as data warehouses is concerned, it's typically used by business professionals, as I said, who deal with reporting. Is generally used mostly by large companies because, as I said, some of these data warehouses could be significantly expensive. Okay. And also remember that these data warehouses have a lot of data. It could go into petabytes or hexabytes, whatever the case may be. And they could, especially if you're storing healthcare data, etc., credit card data, etc., you know, there could be a ton of data. So typically, if you have that kind of large volume of data, only a few large companies, okay, who are willing to spend that kind of money will be able to leverage these data warehouses. Okay, so again, as I said, the audience would be a large company or business professionals in that large company, but essentially the license will be held by the large companies. And as I already said, data lake is typically used by data scientists who want unstructured data so that they can analyze it. It's all raw data. They can slice it and dice it the way they want it and then infer or perform their analysis or their research, identify maybe some patterns. I mean, there is no limit what you could do with that kind of data. Remember that that's just data, and they're trying to convert that data into some form of information and gain knowledge out. Okay, and finally, type of what kind of use case, right? So where would you use a database? So keep this in mind. If you keep that in mind, okay, if somebody ever asks you the difference between a database, a data warehouse, and a data lake, it should be a breeze for you, okay? You will know exactly what needs to be used here. And I have actually seen a whole lot of people who tend to use data lake and data warehouse as a synonym, okay? But as you see, they are not synonyms. They are very different. They're very different animals, okay? And sometimes people also use database and a data warehouse interchangeably. So again, the whole purpose of the data warehouse is very, very different, okay? So it's not apples to apples. They're very different animals, and you should understand these differences very, very clearly. Okay, once you understand that, it's just going to be a breeze. So coming to the use case, as we discussed earlier as well, it could be an e-commerce website, you know, trying to create an order transaction for a product that it has just sold. Whereas a data warehouse could be used for any kind of market research, analyzing large volumes of data in depth. And or you could store in healthcare information. You could also store in certain credit card transaction information, especially if you're PCI compliant. So the idea would be to store large volumes of data and then perform analysis or reporting on that. And finally, the data lakes. So data lakes are typically used to ingest data. And it could be unstructured, semi-structured, you know, like for example, big data. They could be equipment readings, telemetry data. You could just plain simple log, as I said, you know, anything. You could store some streaming data. There is no specific structure over here. As you see, it's like a mixture of a whole lot of different formats and the types of data and data coming from different types of application, you know, different structures. One application stores a flat file, other one is XML. Other one is, you know, plain simple log dump or something like that. So depending upon the applications and the type of data, data lakes are typically used for ingesting them. And then beyond that, you could potentially, you know, structure the data and store it somewhere else, probably in a database. It's up to you how you process the data after you receive. Okay. So guys, these were some key criterias and a brief comparison between database, data warehouse, and a data lake. I hope this is helpful for you. Okay. Keep these points in mind, especially when you go for your interview or your even let's say if you're trying to have a conversation with someone, you need to clearly understand what is the difference between these two or these three actually. Like, don't go and tell a DBA that, hey, I need a data lake, and then you go and ask him to create these tables with these foreign key values, okay? Don't do that. Just because there's a lot of hype of data lake does not mean that data lake is suitable for all forms of data and all forms of work, okay? There's a certain type of data, a certain type of work that is suitable for each one of these entities. Okay, guys, so that's it from me today. Hope you enjoyed this session. Do provide your feedback. And if you like the session, do hit on like. And I will see you shortly in some other video. Take care. Bye-bye.